प्रणमामि सदा प्रभुपादुपदं प्रणमामि सदा प्रभुपादुपदं
Then Rabindranath Tagore speaking, if a gigantic personality like you going to America, speaking to Prabhupada, then any time you can come out successful. Then what was the remark of Prabhupada? I can show you from book. Prabhupada speaking, I can send such a messenger who is just good like me. Prabhupada speaking, I am going to send such a messenger who is as good as me. And then, sending whom? Sending Bhana Goswami Maharaj. Took decision to send Hayagi Brahmachari. Took decision to send Goswami Maharaj. Took decision to send Bhakti Pradip Tirtha Goswami. Now you are going to say, they are all idiot, they are not preacher, I am preacher. How I can digest? How I can digest? Please you speak me. If you are in my position, what you can do? Is somebody going to criticize? Ah, useless. They only went to collect some money and lead their life. If I go, if Bindadevi permit, by Guru Maharaj permit, someday I can go on discussing all in details about my Guru Varga. Bhana Goswami Maharaj, limitless kripa they got from Prabhupada. The limitless, if I go on discussing, you can go mad. How extensive preaching was done by Bhana Goswami Maharaj, and how high level. All. How it is possible when Prabhupada speaking, I am going to send a messenger just as good as me. Like you can remember when Krishna Bhagavan told to Uddhav, Uddhav is no less than me. I told you, no? You can remember. Uddhav is no less than me. Not like a gapping of atom. Even that much difference is not there. I mean, what is Uddhav? That is I myself. That's mean? So dear. Vishwanath Chakravarti explained, Goswami Maharaj is so dear to Prabhupada that Prabhupada is bound to say, I am going to send such a, you know, messenger who is as good as me. And if I going to pass remark, they all went to foreign country fishing. They are useless. They wanted to collect money and keep it their bank. They have not done any Guru Seva. Then how much, what kind of offense I can incur? That is a big problem. Never mind. I am neutral point. I love everybody. All Guru Varga. But I will have to speak it. Without that you can think, whole world can think, really they are useless. So it is my target before leaving this body. It is my target, it is my resolution that before leaving this body, I can glorify all my Guru, all men, maximum. I can try to glorify, I try to project their glories in front of the world. You see how much, you know, kripa they received from Prabhupada. If I can shout and speak, I have received full kripa of Gurudev. If I shout like a mat, it is that cannot prove that you are enjoying kripa. It depends your activity, your speech, your writing, all your activity, your behavior can prove that you are enjoying Guru Kripa. Guru Kripa is not a matter of advertisement. I can make the picture of Gurudev and everyone. My Gurudev enjoying. Not that. Automatically people can know. So they are the topmost sevak. Prabhupada himself sent them, not that he was preaching very cheap way. His preaching was in high level. He always used to speak in high level. Because that was the conception of Prabhupada. If high level people going to accept Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, then automatically. So why you criticize? Bhana Goswami Maharaj is the only man, who was invited in Oxford University to pass lecture on all affiliated university. So later on, when Prabhupada gone, he was declared the Acharya of four Sampradaya. He was proposed as the Acharya of four Sampradaya. Ramanuja Sampradaya, Madhyacharya, Vishnu Sabi, and, you know, Nimbarkacharya. Four Sampradaya. He was the overall Acharya. Now you understand the quality of Bhanu Goswami Maharaj. So much book he wrote about Veda, a translation of Rasamrita, which is next to impossible. All down. So many, I can discuss someday, I promise you. So, Bhanu Goswami Maharaj was, now you going to ignore him. He's useless, he's enough. Done no seva. In written form, you are writing in Chaitanya Charitamrita. That all, you know, all the disciples of Prabhupada, they're all useless, they're idiot. How you can write this? Bhagavan can excuse you. Bhagavan can excuse you, I am thinking. Bhagavan can excuse you. Bhagavan can excuse if you are speaking all rubbish to Nityananda. Bhagavan can excuse if you are going to speak all rubbish, I mean, Gauranga Mahaprabhu. But Bhagavan cannot excuse if you are speaking rubbish to a pure devotee. This is Siddhanta Visha. Anyway, we like to forget, but still we'll have to discuss. Otherwise, all foolish people all over the world, they cannot understand. They think it is a yardstick. They can think it is a yardstick up to this level. This is a standard of Gaudiya. Not that. Not that. To understand the yardstick of Gaudiya Mahan, you will have to take, you know, countless births. Or you can do, provided you are showing submission unto a lotus feet of a pure devotee who is exactly in line with Prabhupada. These two conditions. Either you can take risks, countless birth, or next option, you can show the submission unto the lotus feet of Prabhupada. These two. I cannot make any mistake in Siddhanta. Not possible.